Good morning. Let's take a look inside the offices of the West Hills Traffic Consulting Group, the area's most successful modeling and simulation firm. There's a tense meeting underway between Paul, a staff analyst, and his boss, Jill.
I hate to say it, Paul, but the state DOT called again, asking for a status report on the Marine Causeway weekday morning travel time reliability project.
Jill, I'm so far behind on that project. I don't even know how I'm going to meet our deadlines. I just can't get the simulation calibrated.
I realize that the Marine Causeway is a big complex network with a lot of congestion, but I thought you would be much further along by now. What have you been working on this week?
I'm just trying to get my arms around the data. There's plenty of data. But when I take averages, the simulation can't seem to replicate the traffic counts. It's just not working for calibration.
Having a lot of data is a mixed blessing. In our last reliability project, there was so little data the DOT rejected your findings. So our situation should be better now.
You'd think so. But I have spent most of this week trying to get rid of the abnormal days. I threw out all Mondays and the Fridays, and any days with bad weather. Now I'm trying to exclude any day with a crash. So far, I've thrown out more than two-thirds of all the weekdays last year.
I see. What do you plan to do next, after you throw out most of your data?
Well, then I'll take an average across whatever days I've got left to establish calibration targets for the simulation model. Another problem is that I'm trying to use counts in some parts of the network from 3 years ago, and some are from this year. It's a real monster to try and piece together, and when I'm done, it's going to take forever to calibrate the simulation.
I think we are on the wrong track here. We may be setting ourselves up for failure. Let's take a moment and think about the problem we are really trying to solve. Let's think about travel in this corridor from the perspective of two commuters who drive to work every day, and then, I want to show you some charts in our traffic lab. Consider two experienced commuters in the Marine Causeway corridor, Rhonda and Wayne. A fair number of days in this corridor there are no problems, when travel on the causeway is uncomplicated, and delays on the freeway are minimal. Looks like a great day today.
Absolutely! Looks like we'll make it to work early today. Life is sweet.
However, when there is bad weather or crashes, the corridor can experience severe and unpredictable congestion. Just getting across the causeway can take what feels like forever. And delays on the freeway can be significant.
This traffic is just not moving. They are going to have to start the meeting without me.
When will these people learn to drive in the rain? Ridiculous.
I agree, the Marine Causeway corridor is a tough commute. There's good reason for the state DOT to want to improve travel time reliability. But I can't build a single simulation model to capture all the different travel conditions.
Right you are. The key is to recognize that a single, so-called normal day made up of data from different days is a calibration nightmare, and can potentially give us distorted analytical results. We should be using a more data-driven method that systematically characterizes the full range of travel conditions.
Sounds good. But I need someone to show me how to do this, and fast.
I have good news on that front. I've just read the updated federal guidance on traffic microsimulation. Let's step into the lab and I'll show you some of the key insights that should help you. Complex and congested transportation systems have good days and bad days, just like the people that use them. Here's data from the guidebook about travel in the Seattle area on the I-405. The x-axis is the time that the time of trip start headed southbound in the morning. The y-axis shows the travel time required to traverse all 22 miles. Each of these lines represents one of the more than 200 weekday mornings in a calendar year. It can take as little as 30 minutes on some days but nearly 2 hours on the worst day.
I have the same kind of data for the Marine Causeway, Jill, but have never visualized it this way.
I bet you do, Paul, but if you go through with your plan to boil down to an average, even if you use all the data, it's hardly representative of the complete range of travel conditions.
Wow. What's even weirder is that there isn't a real day that matches up with the average. No wonder it's so hard to calibrate my simulation, but I don't think I can build a model for every one of these days. There are hundreds of them.
Right you are. There's no need to simulate every day. As it turns out, underlying traffic patterns of distinct and dissimilar travel conditions can be revealed through a statistical technique, cluster analysis. In this slide, the hundreds of days are broken into three groups: relatively good days, not so good days, and horrid days.
Three models are a lot better than one average model, and more practical than trying to simulate every day.
Next stop, calibration. Travel time data from each of these groups, or clusters, can be used to generate envelopes of system performance.
I can dig that, Jill, and I'll bet it's my job to calibrate the simulation to produce travel times that lie within these envelopes. That seems so much more logical than what I have been doing.
Correct. The guidelines include objective criteria for determining when to stop calibrating and start analyzing.
I feel like there's some hope I can succeed in this project now. But clearly there's a lot to learn here. I'm not a statistician.
You don't need to be. The guidance walks you through all the steps in detail. The fact that you already have the data together and a basic simulation model means you can get started right away. Let's meet later after lunch and we can work on it together.
Yes, I'm going to consume 6 cups of coffee, a 72-ounce steak, and a tub of popcorn the size of a swimming pool.
Well, Paul, that's quite a meal.
It's what I call my power lunch. See you later.
In the next 4 segments of our series, we will follow Paul as he and Jill learn to apply some of the detailed elements of the Federal Highway Administration's update to its guidance on traffic microsimulation. See you in segment 2.